Ladies and gentlemen, let's get started. How's it going, everybody? My name is ArsheeTV, and I'm here to show you guys my first YouTube video on BIS equipment for Corruption Ward. This will take you less than 4 hours to grind, and I thought you guys would really appreciate this. All PvP, PvE players out there can really benefit from this. You cannot craft it. There's no way you can ever get a combination through crafting alone. You can only obtain it through this one specific quest. Let's go dive right in. I'll show you guys what it's all about. Alright, I want to show you guys exactly what you guys are tuned in for. This is the Spectral Tempioso set. You will notice that every one of these pieces in the Heavy Armor series are going to be all in Strength and Elemental Aversion, Refreshing Evasion, and Corrupted Ward. Make sure you lock it in as soon as possible. It will be at 590 in the purple color, but make sure you can push it up with Umbral Shards to 600 if you have them. Want to learn more how to get more Umbral Shards? Ask me a question in the comments down below and I'll set up another video for you. If you want to know why this armor set is really overpowered and will be a once in a lifetime opportunity for you to obtain, well, the Elemental Aversion and Corrupted Ward cannot be crafted and also dropped. These two pieces alone are already making this BIS. And the reason for it is the damage mitigation from Corrupted Ward alone is going to net you around 24% damage mitigation from any corrupted monster. If they are a elemental type that shoots ranged attacks, it's also reducing it by 19%. Taking those two numbers into account, you're reducing that monster's damage by 43%. This is not including the actual gem slot. The gem slot right now is using a tier 4 gem. If we were going to specifically put a tier 5 gem inside, you can notice you can push up to 6% towards that elemental monster or person. We can put up to 48% elemental damage reduction if you wish to do a specific mutator. And you'll notice right now the mutator on this specific dungeon is void. On our server on Castle Steel, you'll notice they also have another mutator dungeon that is in fire. So you can jump into Depths, which is a corrupted dungeon, as well as the current mutator for Tempest. Inside of the Cathedral, Mara Rosa will give you a side story quest that will allow you to go and start this normal dungeon, Tempest. You do not need to do the mutators. Running this four times, repeating this story quest, allows you to get this chest. And opening that chest box will give you this entire armor set. If you run this a total of 7 times, you will be obtaining not only the medium dex set, which is exactly the same thing here, but in medium armor with elemental aversion, refreshing evasion, and corrupted ward, but the light armor set for focus and intelligence with the same 3 perks. You're going to be able to have the strongest amulet from this dungeon as well, which is the arboreal, I don't even know how to say it, tempios, I already forgot. Long story short, stamina recovery, fortified, and health is incredible, and I'll explain to you why these 3 perks are super valuable. Stamina recovery, whenever you receive less than 50% HP, your block or your dodge is going to receive 98 more stamina. And this is a defensive action that allows you to block or dodge the monster. Whenever you get below 50% health, boom, it procs. If you are already below 50% health and it is in a 30-second cooldown and there's 1 second left, it will give you another 98 and go back on a 30-second cooldown. This is a tank's dream.
Nice.
Including with Fortify, that applies Fortify 30% longer than ones that you apply. And the Fortifies that we're talking about comes from the Warhammer, which is incredible. Every time I do Wrecking Ball and I get a successful hit on a monster, I gain 20% more defense for 7 seconds. And that's going to be increased by 30%. As well as your sword and shield class. If you see my Darion sword, including my fortified shield rush, if I actually click on this specific skill, which is Defender's Resolve, that lasts for 8 seconds, if I have my HP is above 50% health, I'm going to have 50% damage mitigation for 8 plus 30%. Let's go ahead and use it and show you what we're talking about. Pushing it up to 11 seconds total time. And that is also including the perk that comes with Fortified Shield Brush. And this is incredible to take advantage of. And then the last but not least is your health. Let me go show you guys a Photoshop document that I've prepared for you to show you all of the corrupted armor sets available to you. All right, you're gonna get a chance to see the entire Photoshop document that you can use and take a screenshot for all of your Discord communities and help them understand where they can get this BIS gear as well. Feel free to share this YouTube video and comment down below if you guys want to see more. As far as how I had to figure out how to say that name, I clearly did not use Siri to say spectral.
Tempestuous.
Oh my god, I've been saying it wrong. Here, you're going to notice that it requires 4 normal Tempest dungeons. Requirement is just level 60. Finish those 4 quests, you'll get the Soldier's Tempestuous armor stash, and this is the armor set. You'll be obtaining all of the armor sets at once. That means you'll be getting the Dex, you'll be getting the Intelligence, and the Focus armor sets, including the Amulet that is straight up from the first one, the Tempest Soul. I'll show you that in the next slides. You'll see here for the Tempest Soul Expedition, these are the items that I'll actually obtain. You'll get the Warrior's Chest here, and then you'll get that exact amulet that we were discussing earlier at 590. You will have to use umbral shards, about the 50 that you have obtained, up to 100 plus to push it to 600, so you can get that third perk. You're going to see the next BIS equipment, the expedition's captain's helm, all the way across to the chest plate, the gauntlets, the greaves, and the sabatons. Now, this armor set is only obtainable in a mutator 10 dungeon. Thanks for pulling up from newworlddatabase.info. And it's only the depths mutator level 10. It is extremely difficult to obtain this if you're a brand new player. So the other one I showed you earlier is in 4 hours. God knows how long it would take you to gold every single rank from 1 to 10 for you to obtain this armor set at a random chance on the final boss, Thorpe. And it gives you physical aversion with con. Those are the two pieces I want to explain to you right now. Having more strength allows you to do more damage, reducing your con, forcing your team into success at a quicker pace. Physical aversion is incredible. There's a lot of bosses, like Ennead's second boss, does do physical aversion attacks on you. This means a physical ranged attacks on you, including a lot of mobs are also range-based. And so it does do you justice by having this set, but I believe just the other set is good enough to enjoy while you're focusing on other armor sets like your Angry Earth set and your Ancient Wards. Now let's go and show you what it means to craft. If you were going to go down the crafting route and you do not wish to spend 4 hours on trying to obtain this BIS armor set, the Spectral Tempiosos, I can't even say the name anymore, this is the problem with crafting, as the Corrupted Ward is a damage absorb craft module, and you cannot select elemental aversion or physical aversion because it's in the same series. Even Shrieking Fortification cannot be obtained. And so you'll have to select a different one, like Refreshing Ward, which is a great one for tanking. Reduces the active cooldowns by 1.9% after being hit 4 times. Does not trigger off any DOT effects. So it's important to note, as a tank, this is huge, especially if you have large cooldowns, in comparison to 2.8 flat, where you permanently will have it flat. But if you're in the middle of a boss fight or in the middle of a mob terrain, this will give you that cooldown more efficiently. It'll probably proc 2 times, giving you 4% cooldown versus your 2.8. But if you have a bunch of mobs on you and you also have an incredible amount of Corrupted Ward, you don't need to dodge anymore. Just take the hit and get incredible cooldowns and incredible amount of CC for your team. But if you decide to craft like this and you're seeing Refreshing Ward and Corrupted Ward, this is the problem with this. Is Golden Scarabs cost a ton of money? Back when Golden Scarabs were like 7,000. Right now, I think on my server, they're 3,500. And so you would not be having the elemental aversion, which is a flat damage reduction, which is OP for a tank and also for anyone who is running PvE dungeons. Well, I hope that was helpful. If you want to see more content like this, or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments down below. Or feel free to join us on Discord, and you can ask other fellow New Worlders about what you want to do and how you want to play this game. I have thousands of hours in this game. When it comes to PvP, I've played VGIG, to Bruiser builds, to now Healer, and now here we are in the PvE side of tanking. I felt like tanking was a little lackluster. Not many tanks out there are really putting their heart and soul into tanking correctly for their teams. And a lot of drama happens in dungeons that I could not believe ever existed in the PvE side. Here we are giving you guys the tips and tricks on how to have the best armor set for Corruption Ward. We're going to be looking forward to showing you guys the other sets next. I'll see you guys next time on New World.